So once again, good afternoon. We have just seen at the, have had a look at the first cycle, which I revisited later. I would like us now to look at the execute cycle. Remember, we said that basically the long version of it is fetch instruction, decode instruction, fetch data, then execute instruction, store the results. So in the execute cycle, it's not very obvious. We know that once the instruction has been loaded into the instruction register, and the control unit has examined and decoded the fetch instruction and determined the required course of action to take, the execution cycle can commence. Unlike the first cycle, the execution cycle is not very obvious. There are some complex operations. Sometimes, you know, there are operands to be fetched, and you know, and operations to be implemented by the ALU. Now, the steps are described here. We decode whatever is in the instruction register, and then if data is required and is not available, we determine the location of that data, fetch the data if any, execute that instruction, and store the results if any. We shall see how that is implemented in assembly language shortly. Now, the actions within the execution cycle can be categorized in the following four groups. We have the data may be transferred from memory to the CPU or from the CPU to the memory. Also, data may be transferred from an input output module like the keyboard to the CPU or from CPU to I/O module, for instance, the screen. The CPU may perform some arithmetic and logic operations on data via the arithmetic logic unit. And an instruction may specify that the sequence of operation may be altered. For example, the program counter may be updated with a new memory address to reflect that the next instruction fetched should read from this new location. For simplicity reasons, in other words, we can use this instruction to describe that. So you get data from the memory, load it to the accumulator register. And then you get more data from the memory and add it to whatever is in the accumulator and hold the results within the accumulator. So this is what those two instructions mean, and that is what is described in these two sections here. So the steps basically get whatever is in the instruction register, put it in the memory address register, reference that to the control unit to the memory, so that whatever data is in the memory is loaded in the memory buffer register, which finds its way to the accumulator register. Then get whatever is in the, again, the memory address at the instruction register, then reference that memory for the data, and then of course have that within the memory buffer register, held within the memory buffer register, add whatever is in memory buffer register to the accumulator. That's the ALU that does that, and store the results in the accumulator. So after the execution completes, if an interrupt is not detected, the next instruction is fetched and the process starts all over again. And you have an example here that basically illustrates. We are drawing a diagram including the MAR, MBR, IAR and program counter to show how the instruction move AX from memory 7000 is being fetched if the starting address of the instruction is IFFF and the content of the location is 7000 is ABCD. So look, we are now going to move this is the memory address. This describes how we move content from this memory address into the accumulator register here. The instruction is move. So you're going to note also, as we continue with the discussion, and if you take interest in assembly language, that memory locations are identified using the hexadecimal number format. I think you have dealt with pointers. Pointers are an old way of programming and referencing memories. They're dangerous. C had used it. I don't know whether if you're still doing programming, I don't know whether the newer versions of C has obliterated that. But pointers sometimes are necessary. And when you display what pointers are referencing to, you get to see the memory locations. In the locations of the random access memory, they're referenced using a hexadecimal format. So in this instruction fetch cycle, we are going to see how this instruction is fetched. The instruction itself is fetched from this location. So thank you. I think in the next session we see how that is done, and also see how the instruction is executed.